On this video, we continue graphing exponential functions, and we graph these three problems. We're going to continue graphing some exponential functions. Let's start with this one. Graph f of x equals negative 4 to the x. Now what you have to notice right away is the base is 4. That's the base. The minus sign is not part of the base, so be very careful. You've got to do 4 to the x, and then you take the opposite of it. So 4 to the x is going to be some positive number, and then all the y values are going to be negative. All right, with that in mind, I want you to fill out this table, picking some positive and negative numbers for x. Let's do negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, and 2. See what you get. Alright, so we're going to do for y, remember f of x is the same as y, that's minus, and then we've got to do 4 to the negative 2. So the minus sign hangs out in front. 4 to the negative 2 is 1 over 4 squared, so that's 1 16th. Alright, how about putting a negative 1 for x? We have a negative sign, then a 4 to the negative 1, and then that's negative. 4 to the negative 1 is 1 4th. Negative 4 to the 0. So you have the minus sign out in front. 4 to the 0 is 1. Make sure you do not think of that minus sign as part of the base. Negative 4 to the 1. So that's the same thing as negative 4. Negative 4 squared. That will be negative 16. Alright, so hopefully you got the same values as I got. Now if you use a calculator, of course, you're going to have some decimals as opposed to fractions. Alright, so we're going to graph these. Put the video on pause and try graphing on your own as I'm doing it. Now, notice how I started making my graph here? It's not going to work because all the y values are negative. So, you're actually going to have to draw a graph where all the y values, where all the y values are going to be down here. Right, so if we're going to graph this, we've got negative 2, and this was, I noticed a mistake here, I meant to write negative 1 16th. So we have negative 2, negative 1 16th, and I can't even draw that very accurately, it's super close to the x-axis. Negative 1, negative 1 4th, about right here, looks practically in the same spot. 0, negative 1, then we have 1, negative 4. And I have t negative 16, that's way the heck down here. So your graph looks something like this. It's really steep. Okay? So when you have a minus sign in front of the base, you'll notice the y values are going down below the x-axis because all the y values are going to be negative. All right, here's the next one. Why don't you try this one? Y equals 1 half to the x power minus 5. Now, on the previous video, we graphed y equals 1 half to the x. Let's look at that. Here's the video where we graphed y equals 1 half to the x. So we're actually going to do y equals 1 half to the x minus 5. So try that. Right, I've transplanted that table we did for y equals 1 half to the x, but we don't want to know these y values. We want to know what 1 half to the x minus 5 is. So 1 half to the x minus 5 are all these y values minus 5 more. So 4 minus 5 will be negative 1. 2 minus 5 will be negative 3. 1 minus 5 will be negative 4. 1 half minus 5 will be negative 4 and a half. And 1 fourth minus 5 will be negative 4 and 3 quarters. So if we plot those ordered pairs on the graph, what do we get? Okay, I've plotted those 5 points. So it still looks sort of like the same curve, everything is just going, it's going down. But instead of going through 0, 1, it's going through 0, negative 4, which is 5 spaces down from 0, 1. So remember, if we had y equals 1 half to the x, when you put in 0, you get 1. But I'm now taking that and I'm subtracting 5, so the whole graph is just sort of moved down here. So you could notice these connections, or you could simply plot points each time and try to do as smooth a line as possible. So this is just a rough sketch of y equals 1 half x. Y equals 1 half to the x minus 5. Here's one more for you to try. Notice the exponent, instead of just being an x, is now an x minus 1. So you can plug any values you want in for x and y. So go ahead and try some of your own and then go ahead and graph it. And then you could watch and see how I do it as well. So I'm going to put in some negative numbers. I'm going to put in negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. I don't know if I'm going to use all these, depending. All right, when I put in negative 3, I get 2 to the, well, if I'm putting negative 3 for x, that's 2 to the negative 4, and that's 1 over 2 to the fourth. It's going to be 1/16, small number. When I plug in negative 2 for x, I get 2 to the negative 3, which is 1 over 2 cubed, or 1/8. When I plug in negative 1 for x, I get 2 to the negative 2, which is 1 over 2 squared, which is 1/4. When I put in 0 for x, I get 2 to the negative 1, which is 1/2. Now, when I put in 1 for x, I get 2 to the 0. 2 to the 0 power is 1. When I put in 2 for x, I get 2 to the first, which is 2. And when I put in 3 for x, I get 2 squared, which is 4. So there are a few ordered pairs. And then we simply graph those. Again, look at the y values. They're all above the x-axis. So I'm going to draw my x-axis down low here. And plot those points. So I've plotted the points in red, and again, we see this does look like most of our exponential functions. All right, so you might have something that doesn't look exactly of the form y equals b to the x. You might have a minus sign in front of the base. You might have a fraction for the base. You might have something like b to the x minus 5, like in our previous example. So the whole shift kind of goes up and down. You might have the exponent, something like this, a x minus 1, or a 2x minus 1, or a 3x. So these are all exponential functions, but they're modified slightly. So just practice them and be very careful with your computations when you're, especially when you're plugging in negative numbers or dealing with fractions.